Okay, so if you're new to Exchange 2010, you're probably going around through the graphical interface trying to figure out, where in here do I do a mailbox export to a PST file? Well, in Exchange 2010, we actually have to use the Exchange Management Shell. Once you figure out the syntax, it's actually really easy to do. So in this video, we'll take a look at the new mailbox export request commandlet that you can use to export mailbox data to a PST. We'll also look at an example of using the new mailbox import request commandlet to import data into another mailbox. So in order to export mailbox data to a PST file, we actually have to assign an account the permissions to do that. This isn't done by default. Now, the only way to do this is through the management shell. So I've actually got that running here. The command is going to be new management role assignment. The role is the mailbox import export role. And I'm going to go ahead and assign this to the administrator account. Okay, so just before I run this command, I want to point out that this role assignment can actually be assigned to a security group. So instead of having to do it to 10 users, you could just do a group, put all the users in there, and then create the role assignment. Okay, so I'll go ahead and hit enter here. And you can see that it actually created the role assignment successfully. So the next step is I actually have to stop the Exchange Management Shell or exit out of it and restart it. So I'll go ahead and type exit and hit enter. And I'll restart the shell. What this will do is go ahead and check back in with role-based access control, determine that I've been assigned this new role, and import the commands into the shell that I need to do this. So now I'm back. I'll clean up the screen here. At this point, I have access to the new mailbox export request commandlet. But what I'm going to have to do is create a share here. So I'll remote desktop out to one of my mailbox servers, MBX1. And out on the C drive, I'll just create a share for all the PSTs that I'm going to be exporting. I'll call that PST, go into the properties. Under the sharing tab, I'll go ahead and share this out as PST, and then I need to modify the permissions. So the key thing here is that we need to make sure that the Exchange Trusted Subsystem Security Group in Active Directory has full control permissions, both share and NTFS permissions to this share. The reason for this is because when we run the commands, they're executing under the security context of the server, not the account that we're actually using. Also, we got to make sure that we use a UNC path for the file path location when we do the export. It can't be a local path. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and just remove the everyone group here. I'll add back the Exchange Trusted Subsystem. I'll go ahead and give that full control. And I'll do the same thing for the NTFS permissions. Okay, so now back in the shell on my Windows 7 workstation, I'll run new mailbox export requests, and I'm going to do it for the administrator account. I'll open up Outlook here. You can see that I've actually got almost 40 email messages in here, so I'm going to export all of this data out to a PST file. So to run the command, I just have to identify the mailbox. This is going to be the administrator. And the file path will actually be out on MBX1 under PST, and then I'll call it administrator.pst. Go ahead and hit enter here. And you can see that I get a new mailbox export that's queued. So to view the status of this, I could run get mailbox export request. You can see that it's in progress. And depending on the size of the mailbox, it may take a little bit of time to actually perform this. You can continue to run get mailbox export request to view the progress. To actually look at the statistics, you can pipe this command out to get mailbox export request statistics. And you can see at this point, the operation has been completed at 100%. Okay, at this point, I've got a PST for the administrator's mailbox out on the network share. The next thing we can do to test this out is import the data into another mailbox in the environment and make sure all the data shows up. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to open Internet Explorer. And I'm going to go to Outlook Web App. And log in is another user. I've got a test account out here called Mike. works. You can see that I just got a single test message in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to import that PST that I just exported from the administrator mailbox into this test accounts mailbox. So I'll go ahead and clear the screen out here. And this time I'm actually going to do a mailbox import request. The mailbox name is Mike. And for the file path, I will use the one that we just created in the previous step. So that looks good. Let's go ahead and hit enter here. Okay, so you can see here that now we're doing an import that's queued. And if you actually look over here on the left-hand side, you can see that it's all of a sudden importing all of those messages. And at this point, my message count has gone from 1 up to 38. You can see that all of those messages that were previously in the administrator mailbox are now in this other user's mailbox. Okay, so that's two examples of doing an export and an import. You'll want to take a look at the parameters for both of these commandlets. So if you run git help against those commandlet names, you'll see that there's all kinds of options. You can actually export individual folders and things like that. But I think you've got enough information now to get started. So I hope you enjoyed this drill bit. See you next time.